I can't let you sweep me off my feet just yet.
Sorry, feet.
Well, they've only just landed from
what's on your mind?
And I'm so tired of being messed around. You watch me shift my shape and fall. Maybe you could wait for me, I'll do my best to get out of this
cage.
I'll have to face this loneliness. I've been hiding my tears from my mother and she.
So my name's Isabella, I am 17 years old. I go to the Little Yarra Standard School and I am about to commence year 12.
So I live right next to a cow paddock. I've lived here my entire life with my family. It's a bit out of the way. We don't really have public transport even.
I first got anxiety when I was 10. If you were going to put a name to it, I had generalised anxiety. What my mind went to was I couldn't breathe. As I got older, when I was about 15, I started noticing myself get social anxiety. And to this day, I still have moments like that. I started year 11. I struggled with myself and I struggled with who I was when I felt anxious. My mindset would flip and say, you're gonna throw up. And so I'd normally feel nauseous and not be able to eat dinner.
You were taking everything like anyone ever said to you, like immediately, and like overthinking everything, and you kept not being hungry or feeling sick after you ate. You were so anxious about what everyone thought about you. And you want, I think that could easily have stemmed into an eating disorder.
So throughout this year, I'm mainly focusing on the question of how your body and mind are connected. So I'll be looking at this through mindfulness and seeing how that affects and balances my mindset, whilst also it balances my physical health, whilst also looking at how eating nutrients that you personally need and eating a healthy diet and moving your body and living an active lifestyle can then have a really positive effect on your mindset. I'm not at a spot in my life right now where I can sit with my anxiety and be okay with it and not judge myself for it. And I really want to get to that spot.
So it's the 30th of the 12th, 2018 right now. Tomorrow I'm going to be bringing mindfulness into my morning and nighttime routine. However, today and this past week has been hard and almost physically and emotionally draining from new things happening in my personal life. My anxiety has become worse, mainly social anxiety. Today I was out and felt sick, nauseous and self-conscious the entire day, feeling as though I was going to throw up and almost as though I couldn't control my own thoughts. It was hard. I'm a bit upset and unmotivated to start this journey after today.
So I thought I'd come on and talk.
I'm sick of this anxiety, and I know that I have to be kind to myself and kind to my body, but I'm sick of not being able to do things because I'm anxious, and I'm sick of not being able to go places and see people because I'm scared of what they'll think, and you never really know what people are thinking in the end, and I know that I can't put that on myself and I can't be so harsh on myself for just being me, and if people don't accept that, then that's their thing, and maybe it's just good. Maybe it's just a good time right now to just be with myself, and I think that's why I'm really excited to go away to the beach. Heads on up and our feet are dangling, the air so thin. My body is shaking, swaying in the wind. Push me in. I'm on the edge, I'm ready to begin. I was not eating. I had probably one meal a day for a week. I know that it was a mix of things because I was hanging out with this boy, so I was all nerve-wracking and I was in the city, and so I am definitely not a city person. I need my open spaces, I need a beach, or I need a forest or something. And so I think it all kind of got to me and I just felt really shitty. And then it was so strange because I could say and I could tell that I was going to be okay the next day. You take a breath and close your eyes again. I can't pretend I'm not on the edge, I'm ready to begin. Breathing deep and... There's something really incredible about the ocean, I don't know. Just makes you feel, I don't know, just calm and happy. It's like my little home. The sea itself is just so powerful. It calms you down. It has magnesium in it, which helps you sleep. It's just, you kind of feel at peace when you look out to that. This woman called Belinda, she's going to be instructing an 8-week intensive mindfulness course, and she invited me to it, which was so gorgeous. So I'm starting that, and I think it's going to be kind of perfect for this whole year because it's going to be teaching me everything that I would have needed to research about, and all the mindfulness things that I've been trying to research about in this book here. So, what is mindfulness? Is that a big question?
John Kabat-Zinn says that mindfulness is paying attention in a certain way. I think it's tapping in, it's connecting and being present and responding to our moment-to-moment experience, and also with a set of insights into how to respond to that experience. And that's a growing, developing set of insights that we kind of tailor-make to ourselves, I think, while drawing on the teachings and the practice, you know. So how has the course been for you so far, Izzy?
It's been really gorgeous, given me a new outlook on what mindfulness is and how I can bring it into my life.
Have there been any difficult parts of the course?
I think actually last week, so the fourth week, was probably my hardest. I was really tired. When I walked in, we did the first practice of looking at something that you felt painful or discomfort in your body. And then during it, I just felt really confronted. I've never felt that connected with my body, even though I was connected because there was so much pain in my body.
Yeah. So mindfulness is about being with the difficult, uncomfortable stuff and learning how to be with it, I guess, yeah.
I've been using the experience to remind me to check in.
Had you done any mindfulness practice before? Please?
I've never really looked at it as mindfulness practice. And I think you've definitely highlighted to us in our classes that our thoughts are not facts. That saying has definitely helped me because I'm so off my head. I can think for hours. Put me in a room, put me in a corner, I can just plan out my life. I can definitely get swept away with thought. And then from really reminding myself that these are thoughts and not facts, it's helped me to let go of thinking and thinking my way to negative thoughts that can affect my anxiety or affect how I'm feeling.
Having this time I've taken out of my week to focus on myself and be selfish has been the most empowering experience I've ever had. I'm at a spot in my life right now where so much has been changing, good and bad, yet I've been able to grow with it, with my experience, let myself feel and connect. Meditating once a day, being present in each moment, not judging the situation or yourself or others, has allowed me to be at a stage in my life where I'm becoming myself. Focusing on my breath, how my body feels, and allowing me to feel.
I grew up with my parents cooking these incredibly nutrient and healthy and organic dinners and foods for us to eat. And so I grew up with that really healthy home food.
There's a lot of research at the moment about how the mind and the body are connected and the neurological pathways between the two. Eating unhealthy food creates an inflammatory state in your body, and that can create a change in our mental state through that inflammation pathway. So when we're talking about the best possible diet for human beings, we're talking about whole foods that are local and seasonal, and there's a rainbow of colours. And due to the fact you're eating seasonally, you're eating different fruits and vegetables over the course of the year, which have different nutrient profiles. And then alongside that way of eating that includes mostly plant-based foods, people should be able to understand their body better and be more in tune with their own body to decide whether to include meats or eggs or dairy, and include those foods based on what their body needs. When you're choosing what to eat, is you're choosing the right thing for you, not the right thing for somebody else.
We're invited to tune in and connect with ourselves through our practice. Maybe I'm an idealist, but I think when we do that, we kind of know what feels right and what feels balanced. Often people will recognize as their practice develops that certain foods don't suit them, that they don't feel right in the body, or that, and so naturally there becomes a sort of a balance or a shift in the diet that occurs by noticing what the body's asking for. And that in itself is a form of kindness. So we haven't been told to practice kindness, but we've cultivated a natural, really deep sense of kindness toward ourselves that then extends toward others. simply by listening and paying attention without judgment.
My dad makes pizza. It usually lasts for 3 days, so for 3 days I just had pizza. And I was talking to Misha about it. She was like, Izzy, if you're gonna like change your diet, maybe you should just like ease off the pizza. I was like, oh, okay.
Let's just change one thing. We'll just take the pizza out. Okay, so if we're gonna dive in completely.
Yeah.
We talked about last time, you've noticed that the gluten makes you sleepy. There's a fair chance that the dairy might have, or even once you've removed the gluten, you might notice that the dairy makes a difference.
So should I try no dairy for 3 weeks?
If you would be happy to do that as well, yeah, I would take them both out.
Gluten and dairy are inflammatory. We've been able to find through research that a lot of people are intolerant, but food intolerance also creates an inflammatory reaction. And a lot of people are intolerant to the proteins, gluten, and in dairy, the casein protein.
You know, it's really hard. I'm kind of struggling. I thought I wouldn't struggle as much as I am because I was like, oh yeah, gluten, dairy free, that's fine. But you know, I'm craving crackers. See, like almost all of this stuff in any cupboard has gluten or dairy in it, and it's really hard. Like this one contains gluten and milk. This is a bit annoying. That's alright. Ooh, I wonder if chili chocolate has gluten and milk. Yeah, milk fat. It's milk fat milk? Is that a stupid thing to say? Contains milk.
Once you see the effect of eating those great fiber-filled whole foods like vegetables and locally sourced animal products, you'll find that you're quite satisfied with your food. And you just have to go from processed chemical food version to the whole food version.
Fly through the stars to get to you.
So I'm not feeling so great. Really know what's going on.
Life can be hard. And the universe can throw us in all weird directions. But for me personally, I always come back to nature. Because it's my little home. Literally over the street, just there. I was born there. So this is truly my home.
My first question for anyone is, what does it feel like? What does it feel like being you? And what does it feel like being you today? Because every day is different. So when people, quite often, when people present in my private practice, or even in workplace with anxiety and depression, my first question isn't, when did you get it? When are you going to get better? And what are you doing about it? It's like, wow, what does that feel like? And also depression. Depression and sadness are two different things as well, but we live in a society where sadness is no longer appreciated, and you know, our ability to experience sadness, there's not a lot of pathways to support in doing that.
Do you remember that, what was it, that little waterfall that you and Em would always sit under?
Yeah.
Do you remember that?
Yeah. One day coming back from the city, it was so bad, I came here.
Oh, really?
To just go under that rock.
That's so funny, really.
Yeah.
What would you say is your stress, your stresses?
I stress a lot that I'm going to die.
Mm-hmm.
I stress a lot about the future.
Is there, there's a word that I like to use. Is there a sort of a control, a sense of control in all of this sort of stuff? The things that you can't control generate fear.
Yeah.
Which trigger, well, sort of vicious cycle, like, and the anxiety imagines or anticipates them. Yeah.
Because naturopathy is so holistic, it really focuses on the one person. And so after doing this small consultation, she went, food, diet is a huge thing for me. So that I find really crazy. I've been doing the whole health and nutrients thing and I've really been enjoying it actually. I'm finding it not as hard. Like the first few weeks I was finding it really hard, but now I've realized I don't actually have to change much. Me not being able to eat because I'm anxious and throwing up if I eat is the one thing that is defining my life right now. And you know, I know the reason for it. I know that it's just my body going in fight or flight and trying to get everything out. It's just the one thing that I just can't seem to get.
So when you take the time every day to prioritise yourself and the food that you're going to nourish yourself with, you've now made a conscious decision to live a better life for you. Mm. And if we had a whole community of people who were living their best life,
yeah,
imagine what the flow-on effects could be.
I'm on my third week of being gluten and dairy free. This week I've been just having really weird mood swings. I've been randomly tired and just in a very irritated mood. But, I think I'm gonna wait a couple more weeks or even a month or so I can be just completely gluten and dairy free for a longer period, and then see if maybe this is just a phase my body's going through too, because it's never not had gluten or dairy in it. I've been thinking a lot on how the mind and body are connected. I'm loving that what you put into your body makes your day so much more better. So for the last few years, I haven't been as active as I want to be. I used to do dance, which I really enjoyed, and I stopped in year 10. I love being fit. I love that feeling of when you're fit and you're happy and you're healthy. It's like one of the best feelings. And I've realized how much getting your heartbeat going and even just socializing with your friends, it has this incredible impact on you, and it makes you just feel happy and it makes you feel really embodied. And so throughout this year, I really want to look at how being fit or just active, living an active lifestyle, how that can actually affect and have a really good effect on your mindset.
Why would you look Swedish? I don't think that justifies being Swedish. Dad, do you think you look Swedish?
Like, that's the crazy thing about living an active lifestyle. It doesn't mean that you have to work out every single day. It just means to be active and have fun with it. Like, do stuff that makes you happy, not something that you just have to do as a chore. My body is shaking, swaying in the wind. Push me in. I'm on the edge, I'm ready to begin. Breathing deep and slow, losing all control. And all I know is I have to jump, 'cause you are all I really want. There's something just too beautiful about falling, falling for you. I'm falling for you.
Just watch out when you do that kick, you don't kick yourself off, because you, when you're coming out of it, you've got actually quite a bit of a bop going, and you could actually bop yourself off. Yeah. Do you want me to show you how to do it?
No.
No, we won't either. Don't want to upstage you. It's all about you. You good? Well done, Izzy. Did you say you're tired now? You're my kid.
I didn't love myself for a lot of years, through year 7 to 11. I didn't love my personality. I thought that no one was gonna love me. I thought no one did love me. I let all these judgments define me. I was having a conversation with my dad the other day, because I was freaking out that I wasn't going to be able to go traveling because I was scared, and it hit me. I went, it's all self-love. It's all having love and respect for yourself. So now, I have been practicing this new thing. Whenever I'm feeling nervous and I feel that I can't eat, I sit with myself, I notice my thoughts, and then I go, Izzy, it's okay if you have an anxiety attack.
You don't have to get angry at yourself if you don't feel like eating, or if you feel sick, or if you get anxious.
Yeah. I'm still going to have to pay.
You never will notice.
No.
Mm-hmm. But we have to go fit.
So I've been doing this active lifestyle thing for about 2 weeks now. I'm actually really enjoying it. I'm so much more motivated and I just feel happier. I've been really enjoying just listening to my body every day and going, well, what do I want right now? Me and my class are heading off to Cairns, which is going to be so nice. And I'm so looking forward to the heat. So fitness has been pretty bad. I suck. It's not that I suck at fitness, it's just because I'm tired and I'm sore. It was great going on camp. I loved that and it totally made me realize how much you can do stuff that doesn't have to be going to the gym or doing a workout. It can just be going kayaking. I didn't think that meditation and exercise and nutrition could come together, and it's like it doesn't take the anxiety away. The anxiety hasn't gone. However, I'm not scared of it anymore. I feel happy. I don't feel shitty anymore. I'm just going, maybe all this stuff actually does work.
I cannot believe that it is the end. Avocado. So I just woke up and I'm starting my day off with a cup of hot water with lemon juice squeezed in it. Detox your body, and also it kind of just flushes everything out. Breakfast balances your blood sugar levels, it balances your adrenal levels, and it balances your cortisol levels. And your cortisol level is your stress hormone.
You know, I was at a point in my life at the start of this year where I had a pretty great life. If you would have asked me then, I was meeting new people, I was having fun, and I just was kind of loving life. My one thing at the start of this year was that I had no relationship with myself, which I didn't actually realize until 2 months ago, 1 month ago. I had a horrible relationship with food. I didn't take care of my body, and also I just shoved my anxiety aside. I didn't think about it until I was having a panic attack, or I was getting anxious, or I was in the toilet throwing up. At this age, it's really easy to think about this mindful, health, active fitness lifestyle and kind of push it away. It kind of just seems boring. Choosing to choose you and take care of you does not mean you have to push away all that fun stuff. I've been not living this balanced lifestyle. However, I've been drawing all these things that I've been doing this year in. I am just conscious of what I'm doing, where my mind's at, what I'm eating. With my anxiety, I can't explain how much my mindset has balanced. I think the main thing is whoever you are and whatever your lifestyle is, your anxiety isn't gonna go. However, it's there to help you. It's not there to hurt you. Your cortisol and your mammal brain that brings this stress hormone to yourself is there to warn you. And so remember to acknowledge it. Don't just shove it away. I know that my anxiety may come and I might have a panic attack tomorrow. However, I know that it's okay and everything's gonna be okay. And if you do feel anxious, just breathe. Because breathing brings you right back to the present moment and right back to where you are. You can just sit and take a moment and breathe and let go.
There it is. It's on. Okay, let's do it. Fly through the stars to get to you. That's all right.
Is it like that?
That's all right, yeah.
A bit of height would be good too.
Let's get another 6 cushions. First
moment with you. Yeah. Why not?
That's not how it works. You gotta get the slow mo effect. Ready? Go. I'm gonna be able to sit. Go.